Sarum, dear listeners, and welcome once again to Radio Sai Vintage Bhajan Classroom. Today we have a very beautiful bhajan adoring Bhagwan as Lord Rama. This is how the first line of the bhajan goes.
Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama.
So this is the bhajan we will learn now. Again a vintage bhajan which used to be sung in the divine physical presence of Bhagwan in the 60s and 70s. Just five lines, beautiful words and lovely tune. So let's get started becoming familiar with the lyrics of the bhajan.
Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama, Jaya Jagat Janani, Janaki Rama, Nava Nava Komala, Meghashyama, Bhava Harana, Bhadrachala Dhama.
It's time now to learn the bhajan. As you listen to how this bhajan should be sung, please follow after the lead singer and join in so that you get a flow of how tune of this bhajan goes.
This bhajan is being sung in the scale F sharp pancham. Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama,
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 Jaya Jagat Janani, Janaki 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 Rama,
Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama,
Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama,
Nava Nava Komala, Meghashyama,
Nava Nava Komala, Meghashyama,
Nava Nava Komala, Meghashyama,
Nava Nava Komala, Meghashyama,
Bhava Harana, Bhadrachala Dhama,
Bhava Harana, Bhadrachala Dhama,
Bhava Harana, Bhadrachala Dhama,
Bhava Harana, Bhadrachala Dhama,
Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama.
So that's the melodious bhajan of Lord Rama. Let's spend some time understanding the nuances of the composition. Anirudh is here with us. So which raga does this bhajan belong to, Anirudh?
Sairam Vishu.
Sairam.
This simple Rama Namavali belongs to the raga Mohanam or Bhupali in the Hindustani classical music. Well, it is a very popular raga. I need not introduce it again and again. Just that to go through the notes of the bhajan, let us have the raga.
Sare Shudri, Sare Ga Shudga, Pa Dha Shuddha, Sa Dha.
Again.
Sadha paga pare sa sare ga padha sa sadha paga ga pada baga re ga re sadha pada sare ga re ga re sa जया शंकरा भावगोचरा शिवचिदंबरा ओंकारा अखंड ज्योति जलाओ साई मन मंदिर में राम राम जय रघुकुल तिलका चंद्रकलाधर सांब सदाशिव.
यू हैव सो मेनी भजन्स इन मोहनम भूपाली एंड ऑल आर वेरी ब्राइट एंड ऑल्सो वी हैव फास्ट भजन्स.
कालातीताय सिद्धि रूपाय योगेश्वराय नमो.
You have many Rama bhajans also.
Yes, we have.
Shri Ram Charanam, Shri Ram Charanam Bhaje Mohan Raghu Rama.
Yeah.
So, would you like to do an alap in Mohanam?
Sure, brother. I will give a try.
Dasa
As you were doing the alap, I was reminded of another song. Ghana Ghana Sundara, is that also in the
song? Yes.
Ghana Ghana Sundara.
Maybe Arvind sir can sing that Telugu song.
Ghana Ghana Sundara Karuna Rasa Mandira Adi Pilupo अति मधुर 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 मोंकार मो पा
పాండురంగ పాండురంగ ఘన ఘన సుందరా కరుణారస మందిరా.
భగవాన్ యూ షుడ్ లవ్ ఇట్ ఇజంట్ ఇట్?
యా వెరీ మచ్ యాక్చువల్లీ. మెనీ ఇన్స్టెన్సెస్ వెన్ బాయ్స్ సాంగ్ దిస్ ఇన్ ద సాయి కుల్వంతల్.
వావ్. ఎనీవే లెట్స్ కమ్ బ్యాక్ టు అవర్ భజన్ అండ్ డూ ద స్వరాస్ ఫర్ ఎవ్రీ లైన్.
Yes, brother. The first line.
Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama, Riga Risa Sa Risa Da Sa Sa Risa Riga Ga,
Riga Risa Sa Risa Da Sa Sa Risa Riga Ga,
జయ జగ జననీ జానకి రామా, గగరి గ పాప గ గపద పగరి గరి సా,
గగరి గ పాప గ గపద పగరి గరి సా.
వెల్ కమింగ్ బ్యాక్ దర్ ఇస్ అ స్మాల్ వేరియేషన్.
జయ రఘునందన జయ జయ రామ, సగరి ససారి సద ససరి రి సరి గ పద పగ,
సగరి ససారి సద ససరి రి సరి గ పద పగ,
నవ నవ కోమల మేఘ శ్యామ, గగరి గ పాప ప ప ప ద ప గ పాప,
గగరి గ పాప ప ప ప ద ప గ పాప,
భవహరణ భద్రాచల ధామ, గ ప ద స ద ప గ గ గ ధ ప గ రి గ రి సా,
గ ప ద స ద ప గ గ గ ధ ప గ రి గ రి సా.
ఇట్స్ ఎ రిలేటివ్లీ సింపుల్ భజన్, ఇజంట్ ఇట్?
Yes, it is a simple bhajan on Mohanam. Since the Mohanam notes are Shuddha notes and we have many familiar bhajans, we can always, if we learn Mohanaragrama, it becomes easier to learn this also.
Yes.
If you learn Chandrakaladhara, it becomes easier to learn Jayashankara. So yes, like that. So the bhajans in the same raga, when we classify, it becomes easier to pick up and learn the similar bhajans too.
Yes. So we'll do the beat.
Yes, the beat of the bhajan is the regular 8 beat, Aditalam or Kaherva in the classical music. Let's have the count. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1.
Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama,
Jaya Raghunandana, జయ జయ రామ,
జయ జగ జననీ జానకి రామ,
జయ జగ జననీ జానకి రామ,
జయ రఘునందన జయ జయ రామ,
జయ రఘునందన జయ జయ రామ.
Beautiful. So another lovely bhajan from the yesteryears. I think Mohan Rao sir used to sing this, isn't it?
Yes. More than 30 years ago, he used to sing this bhajan. That's what Srinivasulu sir was telling. When we are discussing the lyrics for this bhajan, whether the last line is Bhavaharana Bhadrachala Dhama, or there are some versions where Bhavaharana Bhadrachala Rama. So both means the same, but the way it was sung in Mandir those days was Bhavaharana Bhadrachala Dhama. So
referring to the sacred shrine of Bhadrachala.
Bhadrachala, yes. The Rama who has Bhadrachala as his abode.
Abode, yes. Thank you so much, brothers Anirudh and Arvind Sai.
Thank you, Vishu. Vishu. Sai Ram.
So with that, we are done with the raga and the tala of the bhajan. Let's spend some time now understanding the significance of every word of this bhajan. So we begin with the first line. జయ రఘునందన, జయ జయ రామ. జయ మీన్స్ విక్టరీ టు. రఘునందన కమ్స్ ఫ్రమ్ రఘు అండ్ నందన. హియర్ రఘు రెఫర్స్ టు ఎంపరర్ రఘు, ద గ్రేట్ గ్రాండ్ ఫాదర్ ఆఫ్ లార్డ్ రామ. ద క్లాన్ ఆఫ్ లార్డ్ రామ ఈజ్ ఆఫన్ కాల్డ్ ది రఘు డైనస్టీ బికాస్ కింగ్ రఘు వాజ్ సో ఇంపెకబుల్ ఇన్ క్యారెక్టర్ అండ్ వాజ్ ఎన్ ఏబుల్ అడ్మినిస్ట్రేటర్ డ్యూరింగ్ హిస్ రూల్ ఓవర్ ద కింగ్డమ్ ఆఫ్ అయోధ్య. నందన మీన్స్ సన్. ఇన్ అనదర్ కాంటెక్స్ట్ ఇట్ ఆల్సో మీన్స్ వన్ హూ గ్లాడెన్స్. దస్ రఘునందన రెఫర్స్ టు లార్డ్ రామా హూ వాజ్ ఎ సన్ బోర్న్ ఇన్ ద లీనేజ్ ఆఫ్ కింగ్ రఘు. హీఈస్ ఆల్సో ద వన్ హూ గ్లాడెన్ ద హార్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఎవ్రీ వన్ బై హిస్ సుప్రీమ్లీ ఎగ్జెంప్లరీ బిహేవియర్. దెర్ ఈస్ అ టెలింగ్ ఇన్సిడెంట్ దట్ ఇలస్ట్రేట్స్ హౌ ద సేమ్ డివైన్ ప్రిన్సిపల్ అస్యూమ్డ్ ఫార్మ్ అస్ సత్య సాయి ఇన్ కలియుగ. మిస్టర్ చిదంబరం కృష్ణన్, a long time devotee of Bhagwan Baba, was witness to this. During the old days, at around 4:30 in the evening, Bhagwan used to come down from upstairs. There used to be a Brahmin scholar named Brahman, and he was the only priest in the mandir back then. After Bhagwan came down, Brahman would start reading out some passages from the Ramayana and then explain what he had read about. Later, he would ask those gathered if they had any doubts. Once Bhagwan intervened as Brahman was explaining and told that little group of devotees, "You will not understand what this man is saying. I will explain to you in detail." And then Bhagwan started giving a discourse in which he narrated several incidents that are not recorded in the published versions of the Ramayana. And when Bhagwan finished, Brahman asked, "But Swami, one does not find these incidents reported in the Ramayana." And Bhagwan simply replied, "I am Rama. I was there. I know exactly what happened." Brahman was stunned and very feebly he asked, "Swami, are you really Rama?" And Bhagwan very nonchalantly replied, "Yes, yes, I am indeed Rama. We sing in praise of this Rama. Victory to Lord Rama, victory to Lord Rama, who was the crown jewel of the Raghu clan." So that is what is conveyed in Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama. We come to the next line, Jaya Jagajanani Janaki Rama. Jagat Janani comes from Jagat meaning cosmos. Janani means mother. Janaki refers to Mother Sita. She is called as Janaki because she is the daughter of King Janaka. So here in this line, we refer to Mother Sita, we praise her as the goddess of the world, Jaya Jagajanani. We refer to Mother Sita as the divine energy principle of this universe. Let's move on to the next line. Nava Nava Komala Megha Shyama. Nava means new. Komala means tender, delicate. In the Ramakatha Rasa Vahini, Bhagwan explains about the tender nature of Lord Rama. Swami says, Rama was supremely gentle. However harsh others might speak, he used to reply always softly and sweetly. Though others might do him harm, he never remembered it against them. He sought only to be good and to be of service to them. Whenever he found time, he discussed codes of good conduct and rules of morality with aged monks, revered Brahmins, and learned scholars. He analyzed the mysteries of Vedantic thought in simple words, and like an ordinary enquirer, he posed problems before pundits and scholars for elucidation. The sages and scholars who had mastered the science of spirituality, Vedanta, and philosophical inquiry were elated at Rama's elaborations of the knotty points that he himself raised. They praised his intelligence and scholarship in 1,000 ways. Rama spoke to his subjects even before they spoke to him. So ardent was his love towards them. He lovingly inquired about their welfare and was full of sympathy for them. That is the reason why the subjects loved him as their dearest friend and kinsman. They revered him for his affectionate interest in them. And Rama followed strictly the various rules of living dictated by tradition, whatever be the inconvenience or discomfort. To whomever he spoke, he had a charming smile on his face, a merry twinkle in the eye, and lasting sweetness in his words. No one noticed the slightest trace of anger, dislike, despair, or hate in his face. This is how Bhagwan describes the nature of Lord Rama. In Bhagavata Vahini, Bhagwan says, Sage Sukha said to Parikshit, First, I will describe the Soumya quality of Sri Rama. By Soumya, I mean his gentle, soft and mild nature. He wore a leaf green gown and had yellow cloth round his waist. When he walked, his eyes were always on the ground. His humility melted the hearts of all who saw. No one caught him in the act of casting his look on others. He had always the inner, not the outer vision. Whenever anyone offered him anything, he didn't accept it entirely, but just broke off a bit or took out just a little portion in order to please them. Or he just touched the offering with his fingers and gave it back to the person who brought it. With his father-in-law and mother-in-law, he moved not as a son-in-law, but as a son. He seldom opened his mouth to speak to his sisters-in-law or their mates. He never lifted his face and cast his eyes on them. He revered all women older than himself as he revered his mother Kausalya. He considered all who were younger than him as his younger sisters, and those of his own age he treated as his stepmothers. He stuck severely to truth. He surmised that if his father broke his word, the dynasty would earn great dishonor. So in order to uphold the plighted word of his father and to maintain his reputation, he exiled himself in the forest for 14 years. His father didn't ask him to do it. He learnt of it from his stepmother, Kaika. He never argued or gave a reply. He gave up the kingdom and started straight to the jungle. He acted correctly according to the words spoken by him, and he suited the action strictly to the word. This is the gentle nature of Rama, Nava Nava Komala, as we sing in this bhajan that Bhagwan himself has described in his own writings. Megha means cloud, Shama means the dark blue one. Again in the Ramkatha Rasavahini, Bhagwan explains how Lord Rama, Mother Sita and Lakshmana go into the exile and how Guha helps them. Let me continue the narration from here as Bhagwan has written in Ramkatha Rasavahini. Swami says, After Guha leaves Lord Rama, Mother Sita and Lakshmana, they resume their journey. Soon they saw before them a city which shone brighter than even the city of the Nagas. As they neared the light, they wondered which city it was. The nearer they came, the more delighted they were at the grandeur and charm of the city and its suburbs. Reaching quite near, they took it to be Amaravati, the city of the gods, and they were still more delighted. They felt that the citizens must be gods, not people. They sat under a tree in its cool shade and admired its splendor and magnificence. The people came around Lord Rama, Mother Sita and Lakshmana and asked among themselves whether they had come down from heaven and if they were immortals. They then ran into the town and spread the good news that some divine personalities were coming into the city, bringing great good luck with them. Everyone who heard this ran towards the visitors, and they vied with one another in attending to their comforts. Some placed milk before them, some spread fruits. All looked at them without even a blink. No one could leave them and go back. They stood unwilling to depart. One of them, bolder than the rest, came forward and said, Sirs, your charm and imposing personality makes us infer that you are princess of royal blood. But you are journeying by foot along these rough jungle paths with this lovely lady. You are climbing mountains and crossing rivers. You are hard travelers braving all the dangers of the trek. And so we have to conclude that you are like us, mere citizens. We don't understand how you manage to travel across this forest where lions abound and herds of wild elephants roam about. And you have with you this tender embodiment of loveliness and beauty. Have you no kith and kin, no friends and comrades, no well-wishers? If there were any such, certainly they would not have allowed you to venture on this journey. And so this person inquired into the nature and cause of the journey and put a number of questions to Lord Rama. Meanwhile, a woman advanced and addressed Rama and said, O Prince, I place a prayer before you. Woman that I am afraid to express it. Pardon my effrontery. We are common folk unacquainted with verbal finesse. Your physical charm reflects the luster of emerald and gold, which seem to be the source of your brightness. One of you has the complexion of the rain cloud, while the other is resplendent white. Both are as enchanting as a billion gods of love molded into human bodies. Also, we don't know how this sweet lady is related to you. She has the exquisite charm of the goddess of love. Watching her modesty and innate humility, as well as her charm, we women are in fact ashamed of ourselves. Kindly tell us who you are and why you have come like this. Listening to their prayers and watching their eagerness and joy, Rama and Lakshmana were very much amused. Sita turned towards the woman and said, Sisters, this simple, sincere person with the golden complexion is Lakshmana. He is my lord's brother, a younger brother. Then about the dark blue person, he with the lotus-petaled eyes that enrapture the world, with the long, strong bow arms, this is my lord. He is the very breath of my life. Saying thus, Sita bent her head and looked at the ground. This is how Bhagwan describes how Sita introduced Rama and Lakshmana to the people of Amaravati. And here you find such beautiful description of Rama, so beautifully elucidating what we sing in this line, Nava Nava Komala Meghashyama. He is the most beautiful, tender, dark blue complexioned one. We pray to such a beautiful Lord as we sing this line. Let's move on to the last line. Bhadrachala is a pilgrimage town in South India. It is located 312 kilometers east of Hyderabad and is situated on the banks of River Godavari. It is located in present-day Khammam district of Andhra Pradesh. The town is famous for a temple dedicated to Lord Rama, which is the second famous shrine for Lord Rama after Ayodhya in India. The word Bhadrachala comes from Bhadra and Achala. Bhadra is the name of a sage. Achala means mountain. The significance of Bhadrachalam dates back to the Ramayana era. This hill place existed in the Dandakaranya region of the Ramayana period, where Rama, Sita and Lakshmana had spent their exile in the forest. This place connects to the famous Golden Deer episode as well as the place where Sita was abducted by Ravana. A sage named Bhadra performed penance at the bank of River Godavari to get the grace of Lord Rama. He implored the Lord to be seated on his head, but Rama, who was in search of Sita, promised that he would fulfill the desire after finding Sita and punishing Ravana. Since Lord Rama did not return and fulfill his desire, the sage continued his penance through the yugas. And much after the Ramavatar, the Lord again manifested as Rama to fulfill the promise made to sage Bhadra. The Lord manifested as Vaikuntha Rama in the form of embodied idols. He signaled his arrival by blowing his conch. He was accompanied by his consort Sita and brother Lakshmana. The idol of Lord Rama has four hands with the conch or shankha on the right, the wheel or chakra on his left, and the bow and arrow in the other two hands. Mother Sita sat on the left lap of Rama while Lakshmana stood on the left of Lord Rama. The hill place where the deity sat was the head of sage Bhadra, which was steady as a mountain. And this is how the shrine got the name Bhadrachalam. The idols were found by Pokala Dhammakka, an ardent devotee of Lord Rama who lived in the 17th century. She lived a little further away from this holy site. One night, she had a darshan of Lord Rama in her dream, where Lord Rama said, saints and sages are worshipping my embodied idol settled on Bhadragiri and asked her to trace them and perform puja and attain salvation. The very next morning, she started searching for the idols, and when she peeped into an anthill, she found them there. They were hidden. She poured hundreds of pots of Godavari water on the anthill, which dissolved and revealed the idols. Since then, she used to perform puja daily and offer fruits. She even constructed a thatched hut with the help of local villagers. Lord Rama later told her that one of his devotees would construct a temple at the site later on. Dhammaka waited patiently for the devotee, who finally turned out to be Bhakta Ramadas. So Bhakta Ramadas, the poet saint Bhadrachala Ramadas, was a 17th century devotee of Lord Rama and a composer of beautiful songs on Lord Rama. He was born as Kancharla Gopanna. He was a revenue officer at Bhadrachalam. He was determined to live truthfully till the end of his life. On one occasion, he could not hand over the annual land tax collected from the people of Bhadrachalam to Tana Shah, who was the ruler of the kingdom at that time. When Ramadas went on a survey, he found the idols of Rama, Lakshmana and Sita in a forest. He prayed, "O Lord Rama, is there no one who could build a temple for you? Is not the whole world your temple, but these idols don't have a temple?" Overcome by great love for Lord Rama, he got a temple constructed with the amount that he has collected as tax. Now the ruler imprisoned Ramdas as he did not submit the annual land tax amount. And as a part of the punishment, Ramdas was whipped by prison guards. For every whip, Ramdas went on repeating, "Ram, Ram." When the pain became unbearable, he began scolding Lord Rama, saying, "Rama, I did all this for your sake, not for my sake. Why are you putting me into so much of suffering? I made that crown for you. Wearing that crown, you move about so happily. Whose property is that? For Sita, I made a gold necklace. Oh Rama, that cost me 10,000 varahas or gold coins. Oh Rama, for Lakshmana, I got a golden waist belt. That cost me 10,000 gold coins. I made all this for you and now I'm going through so much pain." But after he poured out in anger to Lord Rama, very soon he realized that it was Lord Rama who did everything and not he. Immediately, he understood his mistake and he pleaded, "Oh Rama, do not feel bad that I used harsh words against you. It was just that I could not bear the suffering. Let this body perish. Let this mean body die. I should not have abused you or doubted you. I know I am suffering because I doubted you. Do whatever you like, Rama. Whatever you do is fine with me." And as he was being lashed, he went on repeating the name of Lord Rama. He just kept telling himself, "Oh Rama, you are burning your own body. This is not my body. You are beating yourself. All this is not mine. What is mine is only you. And I know you are there with me." The moment he developed such strong faith, two boys came with two big sacks containing gold coins to the palace of Tana Shah. And the emperor asked, "Who are you? Why have you come? What do these sacks contain?" And the boys replied, "We are Ramayya and Lakshmiya. We have been sent by Ramadas to hand over the pending tax amount for which he was put in prison." They informed the emperor that the money comprised the principal as well as the interest amount. The money was transferred to the royal treasury and Ramadas was released from prison. Though Ramadas was not aware of anything, Lord Rama did this miracle to liberate his devotee from the clutches of indebtedness and showed to the world the power of faith, the power of working for the Lord, the power of prayer and the power of absolute surrender. This is the story of the Bhadrachalam Shrine and the great devotee Bhakta Ramadas. Elaborating on the name Bhadrachalam, Bhagwan said during a discourse in 1962, "You very often condemn the mind as a monkey, but take it from me, it is far worse. The monkey leaps from one branch to another, but the mind leaps from the heights of the Himalayas to the depths of the sea, from today to tens of years ago. The only way you can tame the mind is through the process of Namasmarana. Chant the name of the Lord. Make it as Ramadasa did to Bhadrachala. He converted his mind into a stable, steady mountain. Swami said, "This is the task I assign to you. Make your heart an Ayodhya by means of chanting the name of Rama." Ayodhya means a city that can never be captured by force. Swami said, "That is your real nature, to be an Ayodhya. Make your heart an Ayodhya and Bhadrachala, steady and impregnable." Swami says, "Install Rama in your heart and no outer force can harm you. Just realize that all these pulls and pressures, sukha and dukkha, happiness and grief, rise and fall, they are like the inhalation and exhalation of the breath. They will not affect you once you make your heart like Ayodhya and Bhadrachala." As we sing this bhajan, let our faith and love for the Lord become steady. Let our faith and love for the Lord become lasting. Let our faith and love for the Lord flow incessantly like Godavari. So that is what this bhajan is urging us to do. Such a beautiful bhajan. And if you spend time understanding every word, it really fills you with so much of purity, sanctity and bliss. In fact, it has to be mentioned that Bhagwan himself has visited this sacred shrine of Lord Rama at Bhadrachalam many decades ago. So dear listeners, let us sing this bhajan once again, the way it is sung in the Prashant Nilayam Mandir, and be lost in its beauty, in its melody.
Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama.
Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama.
Jaya Raghunandana, Jaya Jaya Rama.
Jaya
Jaga Janani Janaki Rama. Jaya Jaga Janani Janaki Rama. Jaya Jaya Rama.
We come to the end of the current episode of Radio Sai Vintage Bhajan Classroom. If you have any queries or comments, as always, please feel free to write to us. You can email us at listener@radiosai.org. You can also send us your comments by WhatsApp. Our number is 9393-258-258. 9393-258-258. We offer this endeavor with all humility and love at His lotus feet.